Okay, right. Now we'll discuss another important topic, instruction set. Okay, see, according to the opcode, according to the type of the operation, all the instructions are divided into different groups. Those groups are called instruction set, right? So in 8085 microprocessor, here we are discussing data transfer instruction set. Okay, data transfer instruction set. Arithmetic instruction set. Logical instruction set. Branch control instruction set. Okay, then finally machine control instruction set. Now we have to discuss all this instruction set here, right? Okay, first we will go through the arithmetical instruction set. So arithmetical instruction set, which performs the arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, incrementing, decrementing operations. Okay, so in 8085 microprocessor, multiplication and division, these two arithmetical operations are not defined. Only addition and subtraction, incrementing and decrementing operation, only these operations are defined in 8085 microprocessor, right? So now first we will go through the addition operation. How to perform addition operation? See, addition operation purpose, here we are using one instruction format. That instruction format is add. Okay, this add explains the addition. Add explains the addition, right? So in this addition, first I am writing here add space r. See, remember, now onwards I am using this r. R means register. R means register. We can take any one register like a accumulator, general purpose registers, B, C, D, E, H, L, flag register, all these registers. So any register, R is mentioned means all this note. Okay, that like explaining. Add R. Add space R. So the operation of this one is accumulated data is adds with a register data. Is it okay? So register data performs the addition with accumulated data, and later the result is stored into accumulator. This is the operation. You got this point here? See, accumulated data is addition with register data. This register is any one data. So these two are adds, and the result is stored into accumulator. This operation is add space R. Right? One example I am taking here. That example is, I am writing add B. Okay, so add B I am writing here. Before this instruction, accumulated data is 56H. Okay, and B register data is 35H. These two. Before this operation, accumulator is 56H, B register is 35H. Then I am performing this operation. What is this operation? Accumulated data performs the addition with the B register data. Okay, so what is accumulated data? Your result is stored into accumulator. Here I am taking, your accumulator is 56 plus and B ratio is 3:5. Okay, 5:6 plus 3:5. So initially 6 plus 5, 11. In terms of hexadecimal, 11 is called B. 5 plus 3, 8 DH. Right. So the result is stored into which register? Accumulate. So after this operation, accumulated data is 8BH. What about B register? B register is as it is. There is no changes in the B register. B register data is 35H only. So after this operation, result is stored into accumulator. So accumulator is FX here. Okay. So complete result is stored into accumulator, and which performs the addition operation. This operation is the basic addition operation. So here we can take this R means any one register here. This R means any one register. General purpose register is there, flag register also there, accumulator register also there. So any register we can give you. So that register operation performs the addition with the accumulator, and the result is stored into accumulator. In this arithmetical instruction set, accumulator is acts as a always destination register. Okay, because the complete operation, after complete operation, after completion of operation, the result is stored into your accumulator. So accumulator is acts as a destination register. This is one basic operation. Right, now we discuss your operation. Right, so now here we have to discuss, this is which type of addressing mode. So just assume here, right, internally performs which operations? The operation is performing in between accumulator and register. Both are registers. So any operation is performing in between accumulator and registers, means in between registers only, then that is comes under register addressing mode. This instruction is register addressing mode instruction. Okay, then number of bytes requirement. See, complete opcode. The complete opcode is only, it occupies the 1 byte. Now it is a 1 byte instruction set. See, why 1 byte? Because in this operand, data is not mentioned. Data means numbers are not given. So numbers are not mentioned means it is comes under 1 byte instruction. Okay, so now to complete this operation, how many machine cycles are required? That is also required here. So how many machine cycles? This complete operation is performs the within the microprocessor. Now remember, any operation performs the within the processor. Already we discussed the processor architecture. Internally, all the registers, ALU, control unit. Okay, so any operation is performs within the processor, it takes only one machine cycle, because the complete operation is within the processor only. That's why I'm writing here only one machine cycle. That machine cycle also opcode fetching. Is it okay? So opcode fetching I'm writing here. Why opcode fetching? First, it has to read the instruction, and that operation is completely within the processor only. So one machine cycle, that machine cycle is opcode fetching. And opcode fetching takes how many T states? 4 T states. Right? 4 T states. Right? See, addition of one register with accumulator, and the result is stored into accumulator. Completely, which performs the operation in between register, so register addressing mode, and after converting into binary information, then it occupies only one byte memory, so 1 byte instruction set, and to completion of this operation, it takes only one machine cycle, because it performs the internal within the processor only. That operation is opcode fetching. So opcode fetching purpose, number of T states are required is 4 T states here. Okay, these are the some important points of our addition instruction. Similarly, in this addition instruction, one more I am writing here. ADI some 8-bit data, right? ADI, some 8-bit data. See, this operation explains I is given immediate data. So what is the operation now? Accumulator data is performs the addition with the directly 8-bit data. Okay, accumulated data is performs the addition with directly 8-bit data. So 8-bit data is some given data is there. This data directly addition with the accumulator, then the result is stored into accumulator. Right? One example. ADI 35H. What is the meaning of this one? Accumulated data performs the addition with 35H directly. Okay, then the result is stored into accumulator. This is the general operation of ADI space 8-bit data. Right, now it is comes under which type of addressing mode? Immediate addressing mode, because directly immediate data is given here, so we can call it as a immediate addressing mode. Similarly, we have to discuss how many byte instruction. See how many byte instruction? ADI, this purpose 1 byte, and some data also mentioned. How much data here? 8-bit data. So this is 1 byte. It comes under 2-byte instruction set. Okay, so 2-byte instruction set and the number of mission cycles. Just observe this operation here. Accumulator is within the processor and the data is mentioned in 35H. This data is taking from input device, right? So the data is taking from input device. First it has to read the data. So input device, so it has to perform IO read operation and complete addition and result is stored into accumulator. So complete addition and result is stored into accumulator means it purpose fetching. You got this point here? So fetching operation plus IO read operation, two operations it has to perform. Fetching operation purpose how many T states? 4 T states. IO read operation is 3 T states. So combinedly how many T states are required here? 7 T states. The number of T states to complete this instruction is 7 T states. Is it okay? So how many mission cycles? 2 mission cycles. Right? See, this complete operation I am writing like this here. I am writing single format or instruction syntax. Instruction syntax is ADI space 8-bit data, right? Later operation accumulator is adds with 8-bit data. Okay, result is stored into accumulator, right? Now it is comes under immediate addressing mode. See, immediate addressing mode is I am writing here IMM. Okay, IMM is nothing but immediate addressing mode. How many byte instruction? 2-byte instruction. Right, number of mission cycle, how many mission cycle it takes? 2 mission cycles. Right, total number of T states are 7 T states. Right, just observe this one. So now onwards I am writing each instruction, first operation here, later which addressing mode, type of addressing mode, later number of byte it occupies the memory, then how many mission cycles and number of T states. So now onwards I am explaining in this format, because here we have to discuss number of instructions here, all the instructions. Similarly, I am writing here ADC R. Okay, ADC explains the addition with carry. Addition with carry. So it is similar to ADD, same instruction, but here C is mentioned, extra carry also there. So accumulated data performs the addition with the register data and again addition with the carry bit. See what means here? Carry bit. The result is stored into accumulator. CY indicates the carry. Okay, same operation, extra one carry bit is there. So whenever C is given, then performs extra with a carry. Right, now addressing mode is register addressing mode. Number of bytes is 1 byte instruction set. Then number of machine cycle is 1 machine cycle and number of T states are 4 T states. Right? Similarly, one more instruction. ACI space 8 bit data. ACI space 8 bit data. The operation is same operation. Accumulator data performs the addition with the given 8 bit data plus a carry flag. Why carry flag? Because here AC is given. Right? ACI. Then the result is stored into accumulator. Right? Then same, I'm writing this is which step addressing mode is immediate addressing mode. Number of byte instructions 2 byte instruction set because 1 byte is for this 8 bit, another byte is for this operation. So 2 byte. Next, number of machine cycles is 2 machine cycles. One is fetching operation and another is IO read operation. Right? Number of T states 7 T states. Is it okay? So just observe all this instruction. Now I explained addition operations. Addition operations are okay. Add or right? Add or and add with register, then addition with immediate data, right? Next, addition with carry, so ADC or next, similarly, ACI 8 bit, right? And we have another instruction also there that is add. Add M. See, remember M indicates the memory location. That memory location is always we have to take from HL register pair. Okay, HL register pair. So HL register pair is acts as a pointer now, right? Whenever M is mentioned, it is comes under indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode because address location is mentioned indirectly, not directly. Yet. Okay, I will explain with one example. That example is initially I am assuming H register is 20H. Okay. L register is 00H. Right. And accumulator register is some 56H. Okay. These are the register statuses. Then I'm writing one instruction, add M. Okay, this instruction explains accumulated data performs the addition with the HLPay register location data. The result is stored into accumulator. Right? See, complete operation, your H register, L register. H register data is 20. L register data is 00. So completely the address location is here 200. Right? So this is memory. Let us assume this is memory. Right? This memory is defined from certain address location to some address location FFH. Now the 200 H location is, I'm assuming here, 200 H location. At this location, it has some data. This data performs the addition with the accumulated data. Is it okay? So HL pair location address is acts as a address of the memory. So at that memory location, it has some data. This data performs the addition with the accumulator. So your address of the memory is mentioned indirectly. That's why these are comes under indirect addressing mode. And the complete result is stored into which register? Accumulator. Okay. So whenever M is given, now we have to write here indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode is, I am writing with IND. Indirect addressing mode. Right? Now this is which type of means how many byte instruction we have to discuss. See, ADD space M. Here data is not mentioned. If the data is not mentioned, then directly it comes under 1 byte instruction. Okay, it comes under 1 byte. So total this complete occupies the how much memory? Only 1 byte it occupies here. Only 1 byte it occupies. So it's a 1 byte instruction set. Then another important point is number of machine cycles. Number of machine cycles is, see, it has to perform memory read operation. Which operation it is doing here? It has to read the data from memory location. Which location? 200H. This is explained by your HL register pair. So it performs a memory read operation. Later it performs the addition and the result is stored into accumulator. Right? So one operation is fetching is compulsory and another operation is memory read. So total how many machine cycles here? Number of machine cycles are 2 machine cycles. One is fetching. See, for any operation, fetching is must. Fetching, later memory read operation. Right? So number of machine cycles are 2 machine cycles. Fetching purpose, number of T states are 4 T states. Memory read is 3 T states. Total number of T states are 7 T states. Is it okay? 7 T states. This is the operation of ADDM. So now we discussed all additional operations. Now listen here. See, similar to addition operation, here we are discussing another operation, subtraction. Okay, so same operations here, subtraction. Subtraction purpose, when mnemonic is used, SUB. SUB explains the subtraction. Okay, subtraction operation. So in this subtraction operation, SUB space R. SUB space R means, which perform this operation here, accumulator minus R. So what is the meaning of this one? Register data subtracted from the accumulator and the result is stored into accumulator. Okay, register data subtraction from the accumulator and the result is stored into accumulator. This is the operation. Right? Now here we have to discuss same which type of addressing mode, subtraction with R. So complete operation in between register only. So it is comes under register addressing mode. Comes under register addressing mode. And number of bytes requirement is how many bytes? Only 1 byte is enough, because there is no data in this operand. So 1 byte instruction, number of machine cycles are 1 machine cycle. Why 1 machine cycle? Complete operation is internally only. What is that machine cycle? Fetching. And number of T states? 4 T states. Okay, so number of T states are 4 T states. Is it okay? So register data subtraction from the accumulator, and the result is stored into accumulator. So complete operation is in between registers. So it is comes under register addressing mode. And this register addressing mode, so your operand consists only registers. So directly we can write it is a 1 byte instruction set, and the total operation is performing within the processor. So 1 machine cycle. So 1 machine cycle, number of T states are 40 states, that is fetching operation. Similarly, subtraction with memory. So what is this operation? HL pair location data. HL pair location data subtraction from the accumulator, and the result is stored into accumulator, and it is comes under indirect addressing. Why indirect? Because address of the memory is mentioned indirectly in HL pair. Now it is 1 byte instruction set. Number of machine cycles, how many machine cycles? 2 machine cycles. One is fetching, another is memory reading. The number of T states are 4 T states, right? It is similar to same addition operation, but here we are performing subtraction. So the memory location data subtraction from the subtracted from the accumulator, right? So first it has to perform memory read operation. So memory read, now fetching operation. So 2 machine cycles are required here. This purpose 4 T states, and this purpose 3 T states. Totally number of T states are 7 T states, right? Now similarly here, this explains SUI 8-bit data. So directly the given 8-bit data subtracted from the accumulator, and the result is stored into accumulator. Okay, directly given data subtracted from the accumulator, and the result is stored into accumulator. Now it is comes under which type of addressing mode? Immediate addressing mode. Directly performing data with 8-bit information. Immediate addressing mode. Now it is 2-byte instruction set. 1 byte is for this 8-bit, and remaining byte is for this one. So 2-byte instruction set. Number of machine cycles? 2 machine cycles. What are those machine cycles? Fetching and IO read operation. Then the number of T states are 7 T states. Okay, so same operation with a B. See, SUB or SBB is there. SBB is nothing but subtraction with borrow. Okay, SBB indication is subtraction with the borrow, right? So subtraction with the borrow, same operation we are performing with the carry bit. See, A minus register minus carry bit. Your borrow is nothing but we are taking from carry flag only, and the result is stored into accumulator. Same operation, register addressing mode, and 1 byte instruction set. It requires 1 machine cycle. Number of T states are 4 T states. Then here subtraction with M. So A minus HL pair address location minus carry flag. Result is again accumulator. It is indirect addressing mode. Now same, all these are similar operation only. Same operation it performs extra with carry flag. So two mission cycles. Number of T states are 70 states. Okay. Similarly, SBI 8-bit data. Accumulated data minus 8-bit data minus carry flag bit. Again, result is stored into accumulator. Okay. So now it is comes under immediate addressing mode. Then it is 2-byte instruction. Again, it requires 2 mission cycles. Number of T states are 70 states. Similar to addition operation, here I explained subtraction. So only here we have to do here subtraction operation, that's it. And these register, indirect, immediate, these are similar to addition only. Okay, so any operation within the processor means one mission cycle is enough. And if it is performs the operations with a memory location, sometimes input output devices, then it takes the extra mission cycles. IO read, IO write, memory read, memory write, these operations. Is it okay? So these are subtraction operations.